I'm night before petrol hedonism tomorrow. Just came down, check a few cars out, see what's going on. Came to see Samhard and Chiro. You can see the stage behind us back there. Gonna film tomorrow as well, but just thought I'd do a bit of an intro to show you what the show is all about and setting up beforehand. Okay, see you tomorrow.
So here we've got Big Chris's car from Gas Monkey Garage, as featured on the show. Some very special Corvettes in the background. A few wipers as well. And a black Eleanor. Sounds very nice as well. Just look at that view. The car in front of the stage.
Sun shining. Looks like it's going to be a beautiful day. Let me just show you what I can see here from the stage. So I've got the stage right behind me now. I've got Big Chris's pickup truck just behind us, the Gas Monkey Garage shop truck. Let's have a look at what we can see from here.
Right, so you can see the Lamborghini stand just over there. And let me just pan across and show you all these cars. Cars are arriving. We've got the Elite Class just over here. And just over there. Now you can see them two tents. That's simply Mustangs. With loads of Mustangs arriving. And back to the stage. And a nice little Ferrari just over here.
Samhard, how are you doing, mate?
I'm amazing, mate. Petrolism life is taking off. The cars are getting in the elite stage. We've got Max Power, we've got muscle cars, Dodge Vipers, and this beautiful man's Eleanor of creation. Recreation, shall we say. Unbelievable, man. I'm glad you can make it today. You having a good day?
Thank you so much for having us. Yeah, it's been awesome. Let's see what's going on then. Cheers, man.
Stay safe.
When Chiro puts an event on and he throws in the mix, you have to be in control of the Elite Class. Puts the keys somewhere, so you borrow his daughter's makeup bag. $1 million or £1 million in this lovely $3.99 super drug bag.
Wow. How you doing, buddy?
I'm alright, how are you?
I'm good. It's looking very shiny.
Well, thanks, mate. Looked like it rained last night. It was that wet.
Yeah, it was a lot of condensation on the cars, wasn't it? Mine's all polished up, looking good. Somebody give me a hand. So, yeah.
How can you tell?
The flaps were like head like clockwork covers, yeah?
Look at the weather, it is like, look at them cars behind us. And they haven't even all arrived yet, mate. Just wait till it all goes off. Right, cool.
For you, this is a beautiful 68. This is something you can aspire to for your Charger. And of course, your Eleanor compares very well to that GT500 over there.
Yeah, let's show them the GT500 just in the background. Awesome.
Sabes bien que fue un engaño. Me hiciste fue un pecado, así mismo me engañaste y lloras hoy porque fallaste. ¿Cómo tratas de buscarme después que tú me traicionaste? Ahora tengo que alejarme. Busqué la forma de olvidarte.
Best music! Oh, no. proceedings. Incredible cars, beautiful people. City's in USB keys as well. We'll take a piece of the action home. Don't forget Petrol Hedonism up on Instagram. Make sure you tag us in your story.
Okay, and we have Chiro's car here. Okay, I've got the gas monkey going on. That is special. Paddle up F40.
Sounds like a real good ride. And you can stop the shops and go, oh, that was fun. There's figures on this every quarter.
See if I can't talk you out of that Lambo. Very quickly.
I'm just with Richard Rawlings here.
What's up?
Hedonism. Say hi to all, Richard.
Hello, what's up?
Cheers, man, thank you.
And this is the car that was actually driven by Michael Schumann early in his career. So that is the actual car. And the amazing Ferrari F50. What a beauty. And lots of Focus RS's and ST's going on down here. Loads of them.
Throwing in government trucks, my stickers look.
And here we have an amazing Zenvo. Check it out, guys. We have Mark Yanomizer's car here. It's been amazing.
Testarossa. I was looking for an engine part and this thing turned up on a kit car forum in America, Lamborghini kit car forum. Saw it, thought, wow, interesting kit car.
Hold on, Scott, can I just clarify? You were on a Lamborghini kit car forum, which kind of confirms you want to get to the dark side at some point.
So I had about a 2-hour drive to get here. We bought the two Ferraris and just as we're coming off the exit on the motorway, the car decided to break down. So it makes great YouTube video. But Sam fortunately had his recovery truck. He came, put it on the back.
So did I.
I did a hunt for a missing Ferrari F40 in Iraq. Saddam Hussein's son owned an F40 and my favorite car, many people's favorite car. Decided to try and find this car hidden away somewhere in the desert. Had a couple of pictures that were about 10 years old and did a video on it, and within a week it had gone viral. It was in the Wall Street Journal. It was published everywhere. Unfortunately, we didn't actually get to bring it out of Iraq.
Yet.
We had Saddam Hussein's daughter take to Twitter threatening us if we ever tried to take their car out of Iraq. So I didn't really want a knock at the door in the middle of the night, yeah, so we kind of shelved that project for a little while.
She was all of the angries, right?
She was, yeah.
What's up, guys? How you doing? I want to thank you all for coming out here for such a great turnout, first and foremost. And I want to say thanks to these guys, Chiro as well. And this is just a dream come true to come back to the UK now and experience this. So thank you.
There's certain cars that you want in your life. There's certain ones that you want to own, that you want to sell. There's ones that you want to have for a small amount of time just to say you've had them. But back in the early 2000s, my brother had a Sapphire Cosworth, and we just basically each week and weekend we used to try and make it go faster and faster for various land speed records on A and B roads around the UK. It was probably ain't politically correct, but it's what we used to do.
I believe that car may be here today.
It's here. It got into a little ding on its way down.
Ladies and gents, you want to see Richard?
Yeah!
Oh, come on, guys. Come on, bro. Woo!
Here he is.
How's everybody doing? Unbelievable. You guys have turned out. I brought some good weather. You like the weather?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, this is good Texas weather right here. So this is overwhelming. I knew that we were coming out. We were going to, you know, be at this beautiful piece of land and the castle home and all this stuff, but the generosity of everybody I've met and just the cool factor of everything I'm seeing is absolutely rad. You guys should applaud yourselves. Get some of that. Wow! So what is this deal? Is it Cosy? What's...
Hey, called Sierra Cosworth, but everyone called them Cosies back in the day.
But it was a four-door.
There were three doors and four doors. So they did various different models. They did a special one called an RS500, which was the daddy.
And these guys actually found your old car.
Yes, sir, they did. They're good friends, and I'm super happy they did that for us.
Chris, are you ready to see it?
Yeah, man, bring it up. I've been waiting for this.
Let's just give a round of applause. It's the current owner of Chris's Ford Sierra Sapphire Cosworth.
That's in pretty good shape.
And I remember my brother, who's got a few years on me, he also had a bigger wallet at the time. And we were sat next to each other, and I think this thing was, I'm sorry to say this, Shane, but I was redlining it. We was doing 174 miles an hour in this car. And my brother looked across with Pete and just smiled, and I watched him push the shifter of his AMG, and he just disappeared on us. But I think that was the fastest I had out of it. I mean, it was an absolute animal.
Do you want to buy it back? Because everything Shane said has just put the price up, bang, 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 bang.
I might.
Well, I can start this auction.
I don't want you involved.
And would you sell it?
Everything's for sale.
You've been watching Richard on TV, haven't you?
I was about to say, how much is this $500 Cosy?
Well, we can have a beer later and discuss. You're going to have about 20. Because I'm going to make sure that this goes in my favour, all right, bud?
Cool, guys. Give it up for Big Chris, Shane and Richard.
Thank all you, right, guys. Thanks for coming down.
So another 66 C2. Look at this. Absolutely stunning. The NSC once and it blattered down rain all the way there. When he got there, he cleaned it. I was there the next day and the car looked just as it does now. Unreal. Keep the area open, please. Thank you.
Guys, tell us a little bit more about your car.
This ain't actually my car. This is Scott. Hey.
Another beautiful Corvette. I could be wrong. Is this a Z06?
Just over 600 horsepower. 22-inch wheels.
So guys, nice slow just... around the arena.
Wow. Guys, these guys are making their way around the parade. Guys, please go above and beyond to give these guys a high five, a thumbs up, or a cheer.
I remember as a kid watching TV, and that was one of my favourite shows, Dukes of Hazzard.
Read the number plate.
Now, I know because I was talking to the owner yesterday, but I know it's a 1968 Dodge Charger because of the headlight covers that flip up when they go.
This car here is unbelievable. There you go. So in the 69 car, these have a bar between them that keep them perfectly timed so they open together. The 68, they open slightly independent because they run off a vacuum system. Little Chris here, not Big Chris, has gone above and beyond with this car. It is flawless under the engine bay. It's got 7.2 for 440. The wheels are like a rally spec. They're absolutely beautiful. Even under the trunk carpet, this car is second to none. It's got a Flowmaster exhaust and it sounds amazing. There's a slightly different noise, which you'll get from steel exhaust to stainless. You get more of a ting and a pop, but tell me a little bit more about the car, Chris.
Okay, I've had it about 10 years. It was fully restored about 7 years ago. So what you're looking at now is kind of a seven-year-old car. It's not a trailer queen. I drive the tires off it every time I can. So if it's a nice day, I'll use it as a daily driver.
And I love the way the car is restored, okay? Most people, when they restore a car, they will go out and buy brand new gauges. They'll buy brand new seats. They'll buy brand new parts for their old classic car. Part of a real authentic restoration is the originality. And when you sit in this car and look at the gauges, there are some slight discoloration in gauges which show you that they are the original steel working gauges from 1968. Thank you, Chris, and take it away and give this gentleman a round of applause.
So Sam is in his element right now. This is Sam's thing. I was going to talk about this phenomenal GT500 LNR
right-hand drive.
Right, what, how?
Just because, okay? Just because. There's no need for it, apart from it being unbelievably awesome.
This arrived yesterday and I didn't even pick up on the fact it was right-hand drive.
Thank you, Hawaii, and thank you. Give this gentleman a round of applause.
Thank you, Sam. The car came out of Flat Rock in 2006 and went straight to Ryan at West Coast Customs in LA. Ryan did a £25,000 customization to the car, which included interior, body kit, exhaust, wheels. It then went on tour for 2 years with Nokia Telecommunications and had its own plane that it traveled in. It traveled to every country in the world as centerpiece of their exhibition when they launched a phone called the Blue Mustang. It then came over to the UK with a company called Dream Machines in London, who put it out on hire to boy band JLS, who opened 39 arena tours, sat in this car, suspended over the crowd, and it was the Eyes Wide Open tour, Out of This World. And then after that, it's been used recently in Bollywood movies, it's been on tour with Tiny Temper, it's been with Courtney Hanson on Power Block. The history just builds up on it.
Thank you again, and take it away.
I do love an S197.
I don't know how this man operates. I don't know how he sleeps. I don't know. I suppose the good idea is he works and owns a hotel, so he can sleep as he's working. But every show he puts on, he builds such an atmosphere. And you guys are all here because you believe in him, you believe in Richard, and you believe in Richie Don and all these
trying to put out there for people.
Just looking at cars.
So you're being a petrol head in his head, right, before your time. So before you can even jump in, put your foot on the pedal, do some burnouts, which I'm sure will happen way before your time, you're smashing it here at Petrol Headers and walking around, getting pictures.
Check out the amazing stuff. Keep being awesome, man. Boom.
It's hard work, man.
Hard work.
I haven't eaten yet, that's what I figured off.
Who's is the Charisma Renault 5? Is that yours?
Yeah, this
silver racing car.
That's what it's all about. Daddy silver racing car. So, yeah. Right, mate. Awesome. Thank you very much. And thank you. Have a lovely day.
Cheers, mate. Yeah, buddy.
Thank you. Thank you.
The funny thing is, you have a hypercar enclosure. I am not a supercar hypercar driver. It has always been a dream of mine to do something on this scale. And then it was also a dream of mine to bring Richard over for an event.
So I know you've all been practicing your woo solo, gents. Are you excited about seeing Richard Rawlins right now? That's what we call our American style whipping right now.
Test of the Gas Monkey studio audience.
What's up, man?
Hey, give us a shout out. Huh? One, man?
I will give a shot at giving you a shout out, sir.
Turn the mic on.
Ollie the car kid.
Ollie the car kid.
Ollie the car kid. I like your style, man.
So, gents, are we ready for Richard Rawlins?
Come on, guys, let me hear you. Wow. Holy cow, look, is all of London, England here? The entire country's here, right?
Absolutely, it's been a hell of a welcome. It's been a hell of a welcome. I mean, these guys and gals have been gracious. Thank everybody. I mean, I see so, there's more Gas Monkey shirts out here than there are in Dallas.
And we've made 192 cars. Over the course of all of Fast and Loud. And oh, look at that, I got some canned in applause. You guys are getting beat by the fake applause. Come on, man.
The YouTube channel is really, really a massive insight into what you're doing now. For me, the barn finds, when you get called up and you go and there's these unbelievable cars. No, don't give me it.
That's Australia, isn't it?
They don't even drink that stuff in Australia, right?
Thank you, man. I'll put that over here for somebody else.
But recently...
That's the other thing. I can actually pull my my unchained humor out now that I'm not on cable. But that was getting a little intimidating. But anyways, if you guys aren't watching YouTube, you got to be paying attention. And we're having a lot of fun.
F40. That build, that was... Buying that car was a stretch as well financially.
Oh my goodness, it'd be a stretch financially today, and I feel like I'm in a better place. But back then, my goodness, it was that was the biggest deal I'd ever done. And you know, I even had a partner on it. My buddy Dennis was in on it, and so I felt like we could do it. I felt like we could get it done. But I mean, who rebuilds a totally trashed F40 from the ground up and makes it better, faster, leaner, longer? You know, you name it, and paints it black. We do.
So people are starting to love.
What?
You come from? There's a guy in a suit behind him hiding rigorously.
The funny part is I know who the guy in the suit is, and you don't need that suit, man.
I know, I made him wear it.
He's just a dirtbag carbat like me.
I met Richard 2015, I think, and what I loved about Richard when the show started, that it was you, man. You know, you were on screen, it was you and, you know, your team, and you were chatting away, and everyone fell in love with the risk that, you know, the voiceover guy, whatever happened to the voiceover guy on Gas Monkey, you know? It's like, Richard bought this car for this week, and he bought it for this, and oh my God. And you need to bring that back, I'm telling you. That was the line that we loved.
I think the voice guy was really cool, and at first when I heard him, I was like, you know what, I hate that. And then I was like, you know what, it's just weird enough to be freaky cool, so leave him, let's make him do all that kind of stuff. Just had to come up here and show off, didn't you, Zach? I mean, there's one way to get a Gas Monkey, you know, just get out of the way. Here comes my Mura. So I got it. You decided to donate this car to the Gas Monkey Museum in Dallas, Texas, right?
Thank you so much for your time today, Zach.
So how much is this $500 Lamborghini?
$499.99 today.
High mileage, that's $100 off.
Yeah. So, you know, it's worn out. It's been a lot of miles. It's got cloth interior, not, you know, come on.
Yeah, it's, I reckon, we'll work something out.
I'll start at, you know, 500 was a little low. I'll start at 500 grand.
Okay, we're getting closer.
I still feel like we're a long way.
We're a long way.
Chris, I need some help here. You got any money?
Reserve is off!
Sold!
I want to say a big happy 30th birthday to Harry from Garage Style.
30th birthday? Woo.
Yeah, man. Woo. He chose to spend it with you.
I could figure out better things to do if I was 30.
And we've got Simply Mustangs over here on the left, over 105 Mustangs over 2 days. And Jason, who runs the club, Mrs. Kernock, said it'd be okay for them to come to this show this weekend on their wedding anniversary.
Excellent. Yeah. Now we got one last thing. We got Ollie the car kid right here. If you're not following his Instagram, that is the kid that I was like when I was his age. You know, I was at the car events, I was at the stages, I was paying attention, and that's gonna be a renter and car builder right there. So Ollie the car kid, make sure you're watching that.
So right now we're going to reminisce of UK Garage Sounds from way back when.
How are you doing? You okay?
Yes.
Oh my God, amazing!
That's good. Thank you so much for coming. We appreciate it. Thank you. I said thank you for coming. We really appreciate that. Thank you. All right. Brilliant. All right, guys. I am with Rotter. How have you there been met?
Well, guys, great. The weather has been fantastic today. The crowd have been phenomenal. And the cars, well, absolutely everything here. Old school, retro.
Can you check my Eleanor out? It's with the Mustang down there.
You're going to go and show me in a second.
Why don't we go down?
Let's do it.
How are you finding it? How are you really doing? Are you having an awesome day?
Amazing day.
Yes, t-shirt.
Perfect.
So what film was this famous from, Lex?
Gone in 60 seconds.
Awesome.
Very cool.
So why don't you introduce yourself and your YouTube channel?
So this is Lexi. She runs YouTube channel Rat and Rossa, and okay. I'm her minion, basically. Yeah.
Okay.
So we're gonna check out your car. Is it open? Can we?
No, we can open that up. Let me just get the keys. Pull it out of gear. Start it up. Remember to give it some pumps first.
It's got a very pleasant noise. I could live with that. So is it your daily driver?
Yeah.
Right, guys, I've just had to delete some more stuff. I'm here with Adam C.
Hello.
How are we doing? How's your day been, mate?
Very well, very busy, very warm, but it's cooling down now.
It's cooling down, isn't it? So have you been down to see my car? What did you think?
I have. I did film it. I saw the N and all straight away, so I know what that is. No, it's really nice.
Simply Mustangs are brought, in fact I don't know how many they brought quite a few Mustangs.
I heard there's 150 throughout the whole weekend.
Yeah. I'm only coming today so I won't be here tomorrow.
Oh really? Okay.
But yeah, so that's why I thought I'd catch up with you today. But no, that's good man, thank you for your time man. You. Cheers for that. Fun. So I brought the Eleanor down there.
Oh, okay.
What did you think?
Yeah, we need to go and have a look.
Let's go
around
and check it out then.
Yeah.
What are you saying, Sam?
See you in a bit.
Right, Richard, lovely to meet you. Thank you very much.
Right, man.
All right, see you later. And I think Richard is leaving now, just the VIP area. Might head off home myself in a bit. And Big Chris as well over there.
Walking down to the car. It's been an awesome day. So hopefully I'll get this out to you guys in the next few days. I'm very tired and I've got a 3.5-hour, 4-hour drive back home. So thank you very much for watching.
It's the walk back to the car. Here we go. Just parked up in front of the stage.